Hey guys, welcome to the channel. I just wanted to make a quick video to show you how to make power measurements for your reef tank. I recently asked on my Instagram account if you guys were interested to know how to make power measurements in your reef tank for less than $20. Did you know that around 90% of the energy for corals come from zooxanthellae, and these zooxanthellae need light for photosynthesis. Energy which is produced by the zooxanthellae is shared with the coral in the form of sugar. So if you're in the hobby for some time, you should be knowing the importance of light for the corals. We humans are sensible to light for the spectrum from around 350 nanometers to around 750 nanometers. But for the photosynthesis of the zooxanthellae, the spectrum ranges from around 400 nanometers to around 700 nanometers. What is a lumen and what is a power measurement? So as I said to you before, the spectrum for human visibility and the photosynthesis is not the same. So lumens actually is used for the spectrum which is sensible to the human eyes. And power is a measurement which we use basically for the spectrum which is useful for the photosynthesis. So if you just want to remember this, lumens is for human vision and power is for photosynthesis. So I've been speaking about power for some time. So power is P-A-R, which is an acronym for photosynthetically active radiation. Before going into the details, I just have one more question for you guys. Why do you think light is important for our reef tanks? Each reefer has his own ways of doing things, and I usually measure power when I introduce new corals into my reef tank and to verify the light which I've been using for quite some time now. There is one more reason why we need to measure power in our reef tanks. It all comes down to how light works. You see, in nature, the intensity of light reduces as you go deeper into the water. The intensity of light depends also on the spectrum. For example, the spectrum which is around the blue color gets faded away at around 100 meters, which is not the case for the colors which are on the other end of the spectrum, that is red, which loses most of its intensity at around 5 meters. This is the reason why when we watch videos of scuba divers, it's usually blue colored. These values are also given by some of the manufacturers. So when you buy your lighting systems, you usually get the power information. So why not just take these values and not measure the power in our reef tanks? One of the reasons for this is the values which are given by the lighting system manufacturers are usually measured in laboratories under perfect conditions, right? But in our reef tanks, we have tank filled with water, we have live rock in it, we have corals which are growing, so there is a different distribution of power in each of our reef tanks. And it is always good to measure power and to understand what levels of power our corals are getting in each of our tanks. Corals usually have three kinds of effects when they are introduced into a new lighting system. So when you bring in a new coral, three things happen. The first stage is the immediate impact on the coral. This impact usually happens on the tentacles of the coral and on the coral tissue. The coral tissues and the tentacles either expand or collapse to regulate the surface which is exposed to light. The second stage is a short-term impact. In the short-term impact, there is usually a change in color of the coral, and the long-term impact is usually on the skeletal structure of the coral. The coral builds its skeletal structure in such a way that it regulates the light which is exposed on the coral. The things you would need for measuring the power is a smartphone, usually an iPhone, an application which you can download it from the App Store. And the third most important part is a waterproof iPhone cover. This can also be done on an Android phone, but I usually don't recommend it. The reason being simple, almost all of the iPhones have been made with similar cameras, and the app developer has calibrated the software for the iPhones. The issue with Android phones is that the cameras are not standardized between manufacturers such as Samsung and Sony, so it's quite difficult to get a calibrated result. So the waterproof cover which I'll be using in this video is this one here. I just picked it on Amazon for around $10. The app which I'll be using is called Photron. I have added the link in the description below if you want to try it out. The app is actually free of cost, but I would suggest you to buy at least a month of subscription for this app so that the developer is rewarded for the work he has done. So if you buy the waterproof cover for 10 euros and a month of subscription for the software, you can be making these power measurements for 15 euros. So the first thing we'll be doing is we'll be wrapping our phone with a A4 paper. It is a standard printing paper which I'll be using. This is important to do because we need to diffuse the light which gets into the camera. So for these measurements, we'll be using the front camera of the iPhone. So these are the measurements which I made in my tank. For your information, the lighting system which I'm using is the Reef LED 90 made by Red Sea, and I'm using 100% of the white spectrum and the blue spectrum in the Reef LED. So as you can see, the measurements which I made with my iPhone using the app Photron is quite close to the values given by Red Sea at the surface of water. But as I go towards the bottom of the tank, there is a deviation which is quite normal. So that's it for this video. I hope you got the information you were looking for making your power measurements in your home for less than $20. So if you would like to watch such kind of videos, let me know in the comments below. Please do subscribe and stay tuned.